Good morning, everyone. It's Joker, and today we are back with another slime video. And it is time for normal battle 2 of Jubilee 35 Catalyst. Again, a max score is possible here. It just takes a certain number of units and a certain amount of RNG, but it is very much doable. So, with that said, disclaimers very, very quickly. Your results may vary. Your box is going to be different than mine. Please use this video as a guide and use what you have available to you, because you're not going to have all the units and dupes that I do. Disclaimer number two is that I'm still a little bit stuffed up. That's disclaimer number one and a half. Disclaimer number two is these are the units I use for protection gauge turn one. And then disclaimer number three is please don't forget to go into your town of Tempest and optimize your space building so your space nuker can do as much damage as possible. But let's go ahead and get started. All right, look at that. The New Year's team coming in again to make life easy for us, right? So gonna be a mainstay for a lot of Jubilees just because of the raw power that Xion gives. We're going to be nuking with Space Lumi this time, a unit that we don't often use, but with the kind of lack of space units that we get alongside Earth, our options are limited. But she is AoE, and this is very much an AoE-focused stage, just like normal Battle 1. So she's physical, so she's going to get the crit synergy from Xion. We're going to bring Milim and Shinsha for those buffs. Diablo's here for the crit resistance down more than anything. And then Rimu's here for the Rainbow Orb Trajan to get the EX alt for Lumi. So this team runs very, very well. There's no poison to dodge here, so you just have to have, you know, the defense and, I guess, dupes high enough to not take more than one damage per hit. That may be a whale thing right there, but I don't really know. all I know is the units only take one hit. So it is a turn three nuke, though, so there is no kind of gimme. Turn 3 is the max score. The normal battle 1, you could get max score at turn 5. Not so much here. We're going to send the 3 blues, though, to ensure that we can get, you know, 3 Rimuru orbs and make it work fairly well. So 1 damage, 1 damage, and 1 damage. They can pierce you, though, and then you'll take more damage than what you want if you're going for max score, right? So go ahead and give away all the orbs to Rimuru, convert it all to rainbow, and then we'll bring Lumi in. Sending 3 orbs does not get us enough for Xion, so we have to give away the orbs to Rimuru first, because we can't do, like, 3 rainbows and, like, 3 oranges or something. So here we're going to spread the damage out. We are super weak point, so we are wanting to nuke with a space physical unit, which is great, which we only have, really, 2 space physical units that can actually do this. Lumi and Violet. Violet, you could definitely sub in. My Lumi is a higher level than my Violet, so that's why I used her instead. I don't use Lumi's other skill at all, either skills of her, because they're just not that great and they're really costly. So here, the 2 buffs from the girls. We already put the crit resistance down from Diablo on, and now we will go ahead and buff ourselves up with Xion. And then I think we send a few of the orbs first, just to lower their HP a little bit, and then we send the Lumi ult. Yeah, so 5 orbs and then the Lumi alt to follow up. You are in danger of taking like a counterattack possible, but we send Shinsha last because she's not type advantage and she does less. But there we go, 450 across the board, and that is enough alongside all the other damage we do to get us over that 1.4 million hump with 0 damage taken because we only got hit 6 times total. And there we go, another perfect score, 51.5. Fairly easy to do, but you do need the units for it. So now let's do some alt teams. Alright, team number 2. Again, the Visions of Coleus team. Weird how we've used the same 2 teams. This team can get you close to the max score. We're just not able to nuke turn 3, I don't think. And we do take... I can't remember exactly, you know, it's been a while since I recorded these on Monday. So, it's definitely doable, very doable. We're gonna do a double single target nuke, though, with Xion and Violet. So, they're gonna be our primary dealers. We've got Earth Rimuru, who may look a little odd here, but we are going to try and rush the alts for Violet and Xion, because we don't have a lot of turns. We're not bringing any rainbow orbs here, so you definitely could, if you want to, instead of bringing... Earth Rimuru, you could bring Visions of Coley's Rainbow and get the rainbows, and that may work differently for you. I didn't try it, but Rainbow is able to start giving a lot of alt gauge to space and earth units, which we are nuking with two space units. So it kind of goes okay. It's not the greatest strategy in the world, but it does work. Alright, so starting up, we did bring Water Rimuru for the turn 1 orb change for the greens, so that'll get us a lot of gauge to start out with turn 1. Earth Rimuru and Blanc both have protection gauge turn 2, so we're only going to bring one of the units in for Water Rimuru, and that's going to be Jean, because she's going to be our strongest nuker, so we do want to make sure she gets alt gauge more than anything. But because we are wind units, and most people here are on the Visions of Coleus team, we're going to do that extra damage buff against these guys, so we got to send Rimuru last, and we got to send Jean and Violet first to make sure we don't do too much damage. And Blanc is still here. She doesn't have gear on. None of the units have gear on, or attack gear on, except for Jean and Violet. So, just to make sure we don't do, too much damage. We get a very good orb change here, though. We get the Violet orb change, so we can go ahead and swap Blanc out now that her trait has been used for turn 2. We could do the stack, or the orb change here, and then we can get the double stack on. We do have one Rimuru orb, which is great, because that means that we can send that 200% orb with no fear of killing, because now that we're going to continually be buffing Jean and Violet up, it's going to look a little funky on our damage. But we're going to start rushing the alt there, and that just gets us very, very close. It gets Violet kind of started out, and it does get Jean's alt, thankfully. But Rimuru also has the alt swap ability, so he's actually very useful here in very niche scenarios, but can definitely work. And he does get the synergy, so it does do a little bit extra, but not too much. And then here, another good orb change with Violet. We can use Rimuru to swap the ult away. So perfect. And then another stack of Lumi. So that's three stacks now. So actually 30% alt gauge that we're getting on Rimuru's skill. And we will use that to great effect here. So now it's up to 50%. Boom. And that gets us the alt for Violet and Jean. If you were somehow able to get the EX alt for Jean or Violet, whoever you brought in first, then excellent. Perfect. But not so much here, because we were lacking on the Jean orbs. If we had one more, we could have gotten the EX for her. So it definitely could have worked, but we also probably would have killed. So there we go. We took out one, because again, we're only doing two nukes here. And if you want to do less damage, you could have just taken out Earth Rimuru for Water Rimuru, and he would have type disadvantage, and he wouldn't have the synergy buff. So if you are in danger of overkilling there, that's definitely an option. So... And you also could have just swapped out Jean as well. Like, if you weren't going to get the EX alt and you knew that, you could just bring Blanc in. And she won't have the extra stacks, she'll do less damage because she's not type advantage. And you'll just be in less danger of accidentally killing. But here, we've got enough to use two of the buffs. So, not super awesome, but it is only turn 4. So, we're going to use the buffs right here. So, 690, and then Violet does 538. So, pretty good damage, and it is enough to do damage cap. It's just that we're on turn 4 now, and we took a little bit of damage. So, 48, 9, 14 right there. Still over damage cap. Not so great on the damage score, and not perfect turn score, but you can still do 1.4 million with this team. So, let's move on. Alright, so remember how I said we're on a surplus of, don't have a good surplus of space units? Well, we're digging to the bottom of the barrel already for the third video. Space guy, gonna triple orb change to greens and give 35% alt gauge to everybody, so it allows us to rush alt a little bit. The hero for the crit, Water Rimuru again for the turn on orb change. Free to play Warrior's Mind Xion for physical characters getting extra crit damage, only by a little bit, but any little bit helps. Space Leon will be our nuker today, since he has an 80% alt buff plus his debuffs on his second skill. He is not skill fused, by the way, so I think his percentages go up with that, but I don't have him skill fused, so don't need to worry about that. And then Space Yuki again makes an appearance for the alt resistance down. So, very much AoE with Space Leon, able to rush his ult. We got the rewind, so we can get the crit on and everything, plus his buffs, and some extra crit damage from Xion. So this, this will work, technically. It's just, it's not going to be awesome damage. Alright. So turn one, again, we will Reamaru Orb Change into that 6 blue, which gets us very, very nice starting out on protection gauge. Leon comes in, and then Yuki comes in. Now that we have two space units, we'll be doing super weak point, because we are space physical. We are not super uber-duper powerful, though, so we want to make sure we lower their health bars a little bit more than usual, because we're not getting that extra 6% damage buff that the Visions of Coleus team will be getting. So we need to make sure their health is a little bit lower. But that's a pretty good hand right there. Three Leons plus the 35% alt gauge we'll be getting from Guy himself. Guy is also putting on an AoE debuff, which is just helps our damage out, and it's for multiple turns. So there's Xion's extra crit damage for physical allies. Leon's buff lasts for two turns, because we are going to be nuking turn three, so we'll go ahead and use that now. And then the hero comes in, so we use Guy. We're not going to use the rewind here, I don't think, because we don't have enough points. We maybe could have if we didn't use the Leon skill this turn, but it is what it is. We have enough points to do what we need to do here. So, all right, Leon comes in. There's six orbs. There's the ult for him and the ult for Yuki too, technically, I guess. And then we have 90 points. So you could use like a skill point gate. Okay, we do use the rewind. All right, we're going turn four then. No, I know what we're doing. All right, so we're going to rewind here and we're going to use the debuffs and the buff. But we're only going to send five orbs. We're only going to send five orbs because we're going to use the crit buff next turn alongside all the other buffs we just used. So there's my thinking. That's right. Sorry, it's been a few days. All right, so we're sending five orbs here. Leon already has the ult. We just need enough points to use Leon's, I think, own buff or something like that. Or no, we just need 55 points to use the crit buff from the hero. So as long as we don't send the hero ult, or the Leon ult, then we'll be able to nuke on turn 3.5, which the game still technically counts as turn 3. So we'll get max turn bonus here, but now that we have all the buffs applied, plus the hero, now we can fully maximize that and then go ahead and send the Leon ult. We could have used Guy again to orb change everything and then send 5 greens again, but 1, 2, and 3... maybe should have done that in hindsight. But then the Leon nuke comes in for 100k, which, honestly isn't that bad for such an old unit. But definitely not, 1.4 million. We're missing about a million. But it's an S rank score, and it's definitely a bunch of older units and free-to-play units. So it works for you, technically. So you can change it up as you will. And keeping with the, we don't have a lot of new space units to use, we're going to use another old space team, this time using the AoE Space Xion, who is magic, so she's not going to be super weak point, but she does have decent self-buffs, and then we also have Space Shinsha, who's giving us that 70% alt damage and the space resistance down on one enemy, so... only one of them is going to get hit super hard. We also brought Soka for an attack buff. Whatever. And then Reamaru and Hiro again are here. And then Romaris, instead of changing all of our orbs to greens on turn 2, she's just going to give us a butt ton of ult gauge alongside the charm effects from Xion and Shinsha if we use them, because I honestly can't remember. Alright, this will be a learning experience for you and me both, because I don't remember how this team ran on Monday. obviously, Reamaru is going to orb change turn 1. We're going to get 6 blues, so that'll get us a double Romaris. Romaris does give us a small percentage of space attack and gives us the 45% alt gauge after the end of the turn and 40 skill points. So it does allow us to use quite a few skills. So we're going to spread the damage out here. I guess I use Soka's future orb on turn 2. Because I have enough points for it. Xion's Pierce buff does last for a few turns, but you see they do have that magic resistance, unfortunately. It does drop at, like, turn 6 or something, but... we're running this already non-optimized, so... not too big of a deal there. Alright, so... what an interesting hand right here. Okay, so... yeah, what am I doing here? Okay, future hand. So green damage up, doesn't really matter. We'll use the vitalization, that's what they call it. And then we'll bring the hero in for Ahsoka and use the Rewind and probably send those three oranges. And then pray that next turn we can get a decent hand. We'll still have that blue orb for Shion, but it doesn't really matter because we're going to get plenty of alt gauge anyways. So doesn't matter too much. Alright, and yep, yeah, okay, so there's a full hand of greens. So we'll use the Pierce buff. We'll use the... Do we use the charm on somebody? It probably would have been better if we used the charm skill from Shion, because she does have her charm strike buff, so it would enable her to do more damage. If we had gotten like a full lucky hand of greens on turn two or something like that, that would have been ideal, because we would have had enough points. But here, now, the Rahmer skill will take over. Boom, there's the ults for both of them. We have 76 points, so we can use the alt buff from Shinsha and lower the space resistance on one enemy. And then we can use another Romerus to give us another 40 points, and that will give us enough for the hero buff as well. And that's about all we're going to have to do. So this run could definitely have gone better, you know, if RNG was your friend. But, I mean, it's already not a super great team. So you're using this because you have nothing else to use. So we'll go ahead and send the orbs out, spread the damage, and then we'll send the Shion ult. Alright, yeah, Shion does pretty good damage on that. And then 84, 98k against that one unit that had that resistance down effect on. So not quite as good as the Leon team, but definitely can make it work. And obviously could have been a lot better as well. But there we go. There's four teams for Jubilee Battle, Normal Battle 2. Again, let me know if this video helped you guys out, but that's it for me. Take it easy, and I'll see you all later.